I guess it's the fate of all critics to eventually keep reviewing bad stuff. Even if it's 1 out of 10 after another 1 out of 10 after another. Hello, it's me, Cush. And welcome back to Cush's Suffering. My suffering for your amusement. So, the Emoji movie has recently came out, and everyone's been wanting me to review it. So first let me give you what's about. Story is about, well, alright. I don't think I need to give you a good description of the story. You know Wreck-It Ralph Lego movie? Well, this movie is the exact same as those two, but all the writers did was change it from video games and Legos to emojis and added or change a few things! But unlike the Wreck-It Ralph and Lego movie, amazing films by the way, I love both, this, it's nothing. It's just a completely lazy written plot stolen from two other movies. It's, oh my god. There's no emotion to it. No good jokes. I will admit, some of them made me chuckle a bit. They did have clever jokes, but none of them made you laugh. Most of them, at least, didn't make you laugh. And there were too many adult jokes! Kids are gonna go watching this movie. Kids! Oh my god, they had adult joke after adult joke after adult joke after adult joke. Why not make it more for adults then, if you're trying to aim towards adults? There's no plot. There's a plot, but it's stolen from other movies. Nothing's interesting about it. I will admit they do somewhat get creative with the backgrounds and how they go to different apps, but it's basically the same as Wreck-It Ralph or the Lego movie. And the bird bro, it had to be the Twitter birds. Not just that. You know how I said all things can be stereotypical? Well, this movie is nothing but stereotypical. Nothing. Even when they try to support feminists, saying women don't get respect, the hacker chick is a princess in reality, and she wants help because she's a woman and she can only be a princess or bride. But okay, then how come Jean's mom, who's a female, was a meh emoji, and the evil smiling lady was, that's female too, so what was the point in trying to support a woman by giving them credit if you're gonna do that stupid dumbass writing? What characters? There are no characters. Well, there are, but you can't consider them characters because they're rip-offs from Lego Movie and Wreck-It Ralph, and they're just, you don't even like them. They're zero-dimensional, they're very lazily written, and they're recycled. Just a few things added or changed. That's all they are. Main character is a total nerd, becomes a hero in the end. The chick who's acts all tough, but is a softy beneath all that. Then there's the stupid hand guy who I absolutely hate. The generic weather girl, news girl, who's always smiling, even has the blonde hair. And then even the humans outside their phone. It's so stupid, so stereotypical. Phones out in five. They shouldn't have their phones on at all! Just stereotypical, it's like all teenagers in middle and high school are spending 24 hours on their phones! No, that's just a stereotype. Yes, I spend time on my phone a lot, but not throughout the entire day! I also hate how Jean's mom and dad, when they're looking for Jean, it's nothing. Not exactly nothing, but they just break up in the middle of the movie with no reason at all. None! That's it! Then later they apologize for nothing happening, but when the mom, who's being a bitch, is saying, I'm leaving, you know, honey, bye-bye. Then the fox says, no, it's my fault because I can change emotions too. And also the music area, where did the boat come from? They just automatically got a boat and they fall in love with water. Of course, Jean and the hacker chick, I forget her name, so let's just call her the hacker chick. And of course they fall in love. Yeah, they're different, they've been picked on. Blah, 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 blah. Why couldn't they show more of Jean being an outcast? It was so rushed. You don't feel for any of the characters. I will give them credit. They do get creative with the act. Like the Candy Crush level was funny. I played Candy Crush at the time of the game, so I got some good jokes. And they were respectful towards the apps they were using. I'll give them credit for that. When it comes to animation, well, it's, how do I say this? The character animation is good, but the design for everything is just like, they got like a few elementary schools who do a quick sketch, and they just made it more into an animated movie made by professional animators. It's poorly detailed. All the backgrounds are basically the same, just with a few changes, the YouTube one, the Candy Crush one. Also, it's strange, I say this is like a movie in Wreck-It Ralph, but guess what? There's a candy stage, and those movies, there was a candy level, and a candy stage, somewhat candy, but they're all full, it was full of rainbows, cotton candy, other things like that. And why am I even comparing two great movies to one shitty one? Why am I doing that? Because it's basically those movies just rewritten. Is there anything good about this movie? No, there isn't. I will give them credit, they did have a good choice of music, but the way they use these great songs is just so, I don't know how to describe it, it's so bad. There's no character development at all. No story. Just adult joke after adult joke after adult joke. Add more kiddie humor. Final verdict for the Emoji is a. Join at the hip, yeah, your sidekick needs you. Life is a trip, and the roadmap leads you. Look all around the mountains you have climbed. It's just a matter of time before we learn how to fly. I was holding a sneeze while I was trying to do that. I'm not going to be uncomfortable. You know, Who Framed Roger Rabbit, Toy Story, Wreck-It Ralph, the Lego Movie, how we get all these great things into one movie? Well, there's that theme, but this time, it's with, well, emojis. They even have cool cameos, such as Candy Crush, Facebook, YouTube, Twitter,